मसला ट्रेनिंग का नहीं है, एटमॉस्फेयर कुछ ऐसा नहीं है कि अपोजिट सेक्स आके यहाँ पाकिस्तान में साइड के ऊपर स्पेशली आके काम कर सके। फील्ड के अंदर लड़कियाँ यहाँ पाकिस्तान में कहीं नहीं है जो जॉब्स कर रही हैं।
Apparently there's not a lot of scope for women in civil engineering in Pakistan.
Construction समझा जाता है बड़ा rough and tough सा काम है, उसके लिए ladies तो suitable हो ही नहीं सकती।
In Pakistan, construction is the second largest sector in terms of creating employment opportunities. It's a solid indicator of a nation's economic prosperity and prospects. Pakistan's construction sector employs a sizeable chunk of the world's 10th largest labor force of 54 million, with more than 99% males and less than 1% females. Women find a very special place in Pakistan's cultural context. However, at workplace, they are generally viewed as unwelcomed guests. They have to take productive as well as domestic responsibilities side by side. Such are the stereotypes in any male-dominated society, and Pakistan is no exception. Is it just because of some preconceived socio-cultural barriers that there is a discernibly low female participation in the construction industry? Or is there more to it than meets the eye? This precisely is the subject matter of a recent study carried out by ILO on gender disparity in construction sector under its program Towards Gender Parity in Pakistan.
The problem is that the majority of the women that are working in this sector are, you know, unfortunately unskilled or semi-skilled workers, and so they don't count among the skilled workers in the formal sector.
Women in Pakistan are systematically streamed away from joining certain trades in sciences and technology on the premise of too much gender interaction in field work and physical mobility. Given this background, they are not generally encouraged to join construction sector due to certain constraints.
The participation of women in the construction sector at the professional level is quite low. And there are a number of reasons for that. Firstly, this mindset that construction is a men's sector only. The second one is unfriendly working conditions. Thirdly, and most importantly, is the lack of access of women to skills development in construction sector. Lastly, there is no affirmative policy being made that encourages women to participate in the construction sector.
एग्जीक्यूशन के अंदर लड़कियां आती नहीं हैं, बहुत मुश्किल होता है। यहाँ बाज़ूकात सिविल इंजीनियर्स हम लड़के भी सरवाइव नहीं कर सकते, बड़ी मुश्किल हो जाती है फील्ड के अंदर। जो एग्जीक्यूशन पे साइट कंस्ट्रक्शन मैनेजर है, प्रोजेक्ट इंजीनियर है, फील्ड के अंदर लड़के ही काम करते हैं, लड़कियाँ हमारे इस माहौल में नहीं आती।
इट इज़ वाइडली बिलीव्ड दैट कंस्ट्रक्शन इज द मेंस जॉब, व्हेयरएज इन डेवलप्ड कंट्रीज वुमेन कैन बी सीन वर्किंग एट वेरियस लेवल्स ऑफ कंस्ट्रक्शन सेक्टर। इट इज जनरली आर्ग्यूड that women, due to their biological differences, cannot take up tough jobs in construction. While the fact is that the women are actually taking up the physically challenging part of the construction works, but they are not given opportunities to do the important part of it, which is mostly the technical. The second major problem is inappropriate working conditions, which discourage women from entering the construction sector, such as absence of transportation, poor on-job facilities, job uncertainty, harassment, and irregular working hours.
Atmosphere kuch aisa nahi hai कि अपोजिट सेक्स आके यहाँ पाकिस्तान में साइड के ऊपर स्पेशली आके काम कर सकें. कंसर्न एरिया के अंदर बैठ के स्ट्रक्चर के अंदर काम हो सकता है, लेकिन रोड की फील्ड के अंदर तो रोड बनाना है 10 मीटर है 15 किलोमीटर है, उसमें लड़की की मूवमेंट बड़ी मुश्किल है. राउंड द क्लॉक काम करना होता है 24 आवर्स. शायद हमारे मेल तो काम कर सकते हैं, फीमेल्स थ्रू आउट द day calm, yes, or the night calm nahi ho sakta.
These are the reflections on the highly informal and irregular culture of on-site construction practices prevalent in Pakistan. All this adds to the conviction that construction sector is not suitable for women.
Dusron ke liye shy feel karna, zara sa kisi ne uncha bol diya to insult feel kar li, ye sab cheeze unki life mein aayengi aur unhe ignore karna padega. अगर वो ये कॉन्सेप्ट लेके चलेगी तो जरूर चलती चली जाएगी.
एंड इंस्टेड ऑफ प्रोवाइडिंग कंड्यूसिव एनवायरनमेंट, दिस लार्जेस्ट सेक्टर ऑफ एम्प्लॉयमेंट इज ऑलमोस्ट फॉरबिडन फॉर वुमेन. मोरओवर, वुमेन हु करेजियसली स्टेप आउट ऑफ देयर होम्स टू सेव देयर नियर एंड डियर वंस फ्रॉम पॉवर्टी फेस ऑल काइंड्स ऑफ क्रिटिसिज्म, टॉन्ट्स, स्कैंडल्स एंड हैरेसमेंट्स. Lack of skills and access to training opportunities is the third and major challenge for women's participation in construction sector. There is hardly any technical and vocational training institute which allows women to acquire construction related skills and adopt it as a profession.
Further courses for the male, we have the institution which where we are running apprenticeship courses for the male only. They have the courses like welder and plumbers, the courses like that. I don't think that these are the suitable courses for the female, like plumbing.
So, despite their participation in unskilled labor job at construction sites, better paid skilled labor such as plumbing or carpentry is a definite no-go area for the women. The survey indicates an interesting fact that among men, more than 70% think that women cannot work in construction sector, while among women, more than 75% think that women can work in construction sector if conditions are improved. The fourth major constraint for women's entry into construction sector is lack of affirmative policies and actions by the government and responsible authorities. This is why many female civil engineers prefer to work as teachers rather than pursuing a professional career in the field.
Out of the female students who have graduated, around 50% would join the field and as a civil engineer. And out of those 50%, rarely someone is willing to go to the field and working as a professional and practical engineer. Rather, they prefer working in the office.
My preference is faculty, but to teach, I need to have the experience. And to have that experience, I need to have some of the jobs of the field work as well.
Convention number 111 is about non-discrimination. And there is another convention of the ILO, Convention 100, which is about equal remuneration for equal amount of work that has been done by men and women. And Pakistan has ratified both these ILO core conventions. But in construction sector, unfortunately, women are discriminated and their access to jobs in the construction sector are therefore limited.
With all these problems and challenges on one hand, and Pakistan's commitments to various national and international conventions on the other, it is imperative to take immediate corrective measures. These measures should enable women to enjoy equal opportunities of employment in construction sector. The constructive measures include breaking the stereotypes and mind blocks, equal technical training for capacity building in construction related skills, equal employment opportunities through access to resource and job market information, improved working conditions to attract and accommodate more women workers, and proactive and affirmative national policies aimed at promoting and protecting female participation in construction sector. Given the enormity of the challenge, it's high time all the stakeholders, including government, civil society and businesses, come together to find a way forward. Once the mind blocks are challenged, it's time for change. By providing the women workers decent work environment, skill-based training and equal opportunities, a substantial portion of Pakistan's valuable human resource can be utilized to optimize national economic growth. Once trained and equipped, the women workers would be inspired to play their practical roles not only as contractors and engineers, but also as skilled workers in a redefined construction sector with a world of infinite opportunities. Despite all difficulties and discrimination, Pakistan's women are true achievers. What they demand is their right to work, to live, and to earn with equality for their own socio-economic uplift. They know the road ahead is not easy, but they are ready to face it, to change it.
Maybe I'm able to bring about a change in the world. I always look forward to that, that someday, sometime, my generation or all generations coming up next to me will make a difference in the world.